Pixie, doctors came to you with an idea, as I said, of this risky procedure that had only been used in Israel and had never been used in America. So you were faced with this decision. You want him obviously well, but the idea of being an experiment is also, I'm sure, very frightening. What made you decide to try it?
It was really a Hail Mary for us. He wasn't improving. The horrible thing about COVID is there's a lot of back and forth. It's, you know, two good days, one bad day, three good days, two bad days. And just nothing was working. And there was hope. And I just snatched at it because he needed something, anything.
So 12 days after you got the injections, Edward, you started showing signs of life. You gave a wave, a thumbs up to Pixie and the kids. To your point, Pixie, it's up and down. So how do you feel when you start to see some results? I would imagine it's tough to hang on to the hope because it is so up and down.
Yeah, well, after he received the treatment, we started noticing a pattern of it was one good day after the other. You know, when we finally were able to with him and he could actually acknowledge us, it was the best.
Doctor, I've got to tell you, you know, I was thinking about when you go into a family and you say, this might work, he will be the first. How do you make that pitch? Do you go in with a smile? because that's a tough one. It's a Hail Mary, as Pixie called it.
You know, by the time that became available as an option, Pixie and I had had multiple conversations, so we were, you know, giving update to her on his condition. And as soon as this became available, we called her and I said, you know, this came up and I think we should do it.
Were there things like this being discussed within the medical community? I've heard of this. How do you come across this information?
Thankfully, we had the connections at the Institute of Clinical Research, and as soon as that became available, we were able to get it.
How does that treatment work? How does it work, and is it still being used?
Yeah, so it's a treatment that's been around. These are cells that are harvested from human placenta, and the idea is that these cells allow the body to help with the inflammation that causes all the symptoms and damage from COVID, and for the scar tissue to heal. So we don't fully understand how it works, but this pleuristem will be used in people with COVID who are on the ventilator. But this time it's gonna be given sooner when they become intubated.
Ed, going back to the theme of defying gravity, you defied these odds with all of the success you've had in your career, in your life, being a workaholic. You have this new act for you. Have you talked about what that looks like? What do you do with this time now that in so many ways you've been given?
Well, I think I just take every day by day. I think that when you wake up and you realize that 5 weeks have passed and you had absolutely no idea that occurred, you have a greater appreciation for every sunrise and every sunset. I think that I hope that our story is one of hope and inspiration to others. I think that's the reason why we've been trying to reach out to everybody we know to let them know that this is a serious illness. The virus is not something to take lightly. And it's through our hope and our strength and our inspiration that defying odds and truly defying gravity is something that we hope this treatment becomes available for others if needed. And really just to take one day at a time to hold your family tight and remember that the most important things are those who are dearest to you and closest to you.